Hello dear friends, I hope you all are well. Today we are going to study about warrant of arrest. In the yesterday's class we studied about summons. What is a summon? It is a part of issue of process to compel attendance of a person, appearance of a person before the court. So it has four parts as we discussed yesterday. It's summon, it's warrant, proclamation and attachment. In last class we studied about summons. In today's class we are going to discuss what is warrant of arrest. So there are different types of warrant, as we all know. That first death warrant, which is in limelight these days, Nirbhaya convicts death warrant. There is warrant of appointment, and then there is warrant of arrest, which is provided under section 70 of the CRPC. So today we are going to discuss from section 70 to section 77 of the CRPC. So first we will come to the warrant of arrest. What is warrant of arrest? It is provided in the chapter 6 of the CRPC, part B, starting from section 71. So as we started from section 60 yesterday, section 60 talks about form of summons. In the same way, section 70 talks about form of warrant. So what is the difference between these two sections is that section 60 says that summons should be in writing, it should be in duplicate, it should be signed by the presiding officer or any other person, and it should be sealed. The seal of the court should also be there. But unlike summons, the warrant of arrest can only be signed by the presiding officer of the court, not any other person. Again, a duplicate warrant is not issued. In last class, I told you that a summons is issued in duplicate. The purpose is that a copy of that summons is to be tendered or delivered to the person against whom it has been issued. But here, a copy of warrant is not delivered to the person. Instead, a copy of warrant is directed to a person, to a police officer or to a person for the arrest of any other person. Now, the requirement of section 70 is that the warrant should be in writing, it should be signed by the presiding officer of the court, and also the seal should be mentioned over that warrant. Again, if a warrant has been issued against for the arrest of any person, that warrant should remain in force until it has been executed or it has been cancelled. That means if a warrant has been issued for the arrest of a person, that person must be arrested. If he is not been arrested at a due date, the warrant will still remain in force until and unless that person is arrested finally. Or in other case, if that warrant has been cancelled by the court, if it has not been cancelled by the court, it will remain in force. So this is the requirement of section 70. What are those? First, the warrant should be in writing, it should be signed by the presiding officer of that court, it should the seal of that court should also be there. It will remain in force until it has been executed or it has been cancelled. Okay, now we will move to section 71. Now suppose in a case court feels that, the court issuing the warrant feels that the person should not be put behind the bars. Here there is a case in which the person can be left out, or the person can be released on furnishing a security. In that case, the court will direct, if the court feels that in the court's restriction, the court will direct by an endorsement that the security should be taken from that person and that person should be released from the custody of the police. The police officer who has got this warrant with the endorsement of the court, what he will do? He will go to that person, he will take security from that person, he will also take the bond from that person. And also he will take the endorsement of the sureties who are going to be there as a surety for that person. So all these things has to be mentioned under the warrant, under the endorsement issued by the court. If the court feels that security is to be taken from the person against whom the warrant is issued, all the things will be mentioned. The number of sureties which are required in this case, the amount for which the person and the amount for which the sureties will be bound, it should also be mentioned in the warrant. And time on which the person has to be present or attend the court. So all these things should be mentioned in the endorsement under the arrangement of section 71. Now, the police officer taking this endorsement, taking this warrant, will go to the person, will take security from him and return it back to the court, forward this bond to the court, and he shall release that person, or he will not arrest that person, will not take him into custody, and only tell him that you have to be present before the court on this time, on this date, on this time mentioned as per the warrant. So this is the arrangement of section 71. Now we will move to section 72. Section 72 says to whom the warrant will be directed. It means who will execute the warrant. There are three persons. First, the court issuing the warrant. Second, the person to whom it is directed. That means the person who will execute this warrant. And the third person against whom it is issued. Means the person who is being to be arrested, who is going to be arrested by the person who is executing the warrant. Now, ordinarily, it is to be directed to a police officer, one or more police officers, as per the discretion of the court. Generally, ordinarily, it is to be directed to a police officer. But suppose in any case a police officer is not available, then the court may also direct any other person to execute this warrant, or a warrant may be directed to any other person apart from the police officer. Now again, the police officer or the police officers will execute the warrant. Suppose in a case there are two police officers to whom the warrant is directed, then any police officer against to whom this warrant has been directed may execute the warrant and may arrest that person against whom it has been issued. Either one of them or all of them or more than one of them may execute this warrant. Now we will move to section 73. This is a special arrangement. Suppose in a case, it is a case related to persons who is a proclaimed offender, who is an escaped convict, or person who has committed a non-variable offence and is trying to escape the arrest. Now, person evading the arrest, this section applies to these type of persons. Now, what will happen in this case? In this case, the warrant will be directed to a person instead of police officer, to a person having the charge of a property. Property means a land, a building, etc., etc., over which there is a doubt, there is a reason to believe that the person who is a proclaimed offender, escaped convict, or person accused of a non-variable offense is going to come, is going to visit. So the person having charge of that property will arrest that person, or will arrest that person, that means execute the warrant and forward it to the court which has issued this warrant. So let us take an example to understand this section. I must drop this section 73, whatever has been written here. Don't worry, I'll send you the snapshot. So the arrangement of section 73 is something like this. Suppose this is a land. This land belongs to Mr. A. And this is Mr. X. Mr. X is a proclaimed offender, or he may be a escaped convict, or he may be a accused of non-variable offence. And the court, let's take up C. C is the court. Court thinks that this person X might visit this place. So what court will do? Court will direct a warrant to Mr. A, and Mr. A will acknowledge the receipt of this warrant. Mr. A will say that I have received this warrant, and whenever this person X comes to my property, I will arrest him and forward it to the nearest police station. So this is the arrangement of section 73. Very simple. I hope it is clear. Now we will move on to arrangement of section 74. So the warrant directed to police officer can be executed by another police officer. Suppose a warrant has been issued, directed by the court to Mr. W. And Mr. W cannot himself execute the warrant, that means Mr. W cannot himself arrest the person, then what he may do? He may endorse this warrant to another police officer, Mr. M. Now, this warrant can be executed by Mr. M. Now, Mr. M can also arrest the person against whom this warrant has been issued. So, this is the arrangement of section 74. Now, we will move to section 75. 75 says, notification of substance of warrant. You all must have seen in Hindi movies that a police officer arrives at the door of a person and tells him that I am here to arrest you, and the person in very rude manner asks him, where is the warrant, where have you got any papers to arrest me? Then the police officer shows him that this is the warrant of arrest for you. So all this happens because of this arrangement of section 75. Section 75 requires that the police officer or the person who is going to execute the warrant, who is going to arrest that person, will tell the substance of the warrant. If required, he may also give the give the actual warrant to him for reference. The person who is going to be arrested will see the contents of that warrant and will deliver himself in the custody of that person, and then the arrest of that person will happen and rest provisions will apply. Now we move to section 76. Section 76 is related to section 57. This says that person arrested shall be presented before the nearest magistrate within 24 hours. In the same way, section 76 says that when a police officer having the warrant for arrest of any person goes to that person, arrests that person, now after this arrest, that person who is arrested has to be brought before the court which has issued the warrant, brought before that court within the time period of 24 hours, excluding the time for the journey or the voyage from bringing that person before this court. So the maximum time period for bringing that person, forwarding the person before the court is 24 hours, excluding the time for journey. So this is the arrangement of section 76. If you want to remember presentation of forwarding of any person before the court, so two sections are relevant, section 57 and section 76. Section 57 is also relevant and section 76 is also relevant. So if you want to remember, you can write it as 576, 57 and 76. So 576 is a code to remember these two provisions. This is how you can mug up or learn these provisions. Now, arrangement about section 77. So section 77 says that where warrant may be executed. So section 77 says that a warrant may be executed in any place in India. What we have studied in section 70 is that a warrant until executed will remain in force. So suppose a police officer has got a warrant for arrest of any person, it will remain in force until it is executed. And now a police officer has a limited local jurisdiction. The police officer can function only under his local jurisdiction. But section 77 gives the power to the police officer to go beyond his local jurisdiction and execute that warrant throughout the territory of India. That means it can be executed, the person can be arrested from any place, anywhere inside the territory of India. So the warrant can be executed at any place in India. This is the arrangement of section 77. It is somewhat related to section 48 of the CRPC, which says that in a pursuit, when a police officer is pursuing any offender, he can arrest him throughout the territory of India. Suppose there is a pursuit going on, a police officer is going to arrest an accused, and accused is absconding, he is going beyond the local limits of that police officer. Now the police officer may follow him till the boundaries of India, till the boundaries of territory of India, and arrest him. So this is the arrangement of CRPC. Likewise, section 77 and section 48 are related. It has 48 says arrest can be beyond the local limits, a person can be pursued throughout the territory of India. In the same way, section 77 says that a warrant may be executed beyond the jurisdiction of a person, local jurisdiction of a police officer. It may be executed in any place in India, anywhere in India. So this is the arrangement for executing of the warrant. Now this chapter, this part, part B, is starts from section 70 and ends at section 81. Now the further sections are the arrangement of executing a warrant beyond the local jurisdiction. Suppose a police officer gets a warrant for the arrest of a person and the person resides outside his local jurisdiction. Now suppose, let us take an example to understand this. Mr. A is a police officer. Mr. A has local jurisdiction over this police station. This police station is X. Now Mr. A has to execute a warrant. That means Mr. A has to arrest Mr. B. Now Mr. B resides in the local jurisdiction of another police station, that is Y. Now what he will do? What Mr. A will do? Mr. B resides here and not at X. Mr. B resides at Y, not at X. But Mr. A has to arrest Mr. B. Mr. B resides at Y, which is outside the jurisdiction of Mr. A. What he will do? So the arrangement under the CRPC has been made under various sections. The relevant sections are section 79, 80, 81, which we will study in the next class, along with proclamation and attachment. So in the next class, we'll be dealing with section 78 onwards till section 86. 87 I have already discussed. So in tomorrow's class, I mean in the next class, we will discuss about section 78 onwards to section 86 and also section 88, 89 and 90. So this was the whole discussion about the warrant of arrest. I hope it would be clear to you how the warrant is issued and how it is executed within the jurisdiction of a police station. Outside the jurisdiction, we will study in the next class. In case you have any doubt, you can contact me on my email ID or you can even call me. I will also be available on WhatsApp. And thank you for watching. That's it.